First of all, we're not gathered here as a party. We're here as people of River State, leaders, elders of River State. So this gathering has nothing to do with party. But let me thank everybody for coming to this press conference. That the River State government and leaders of the state are meeting here today to let the world know that we have watched with keen interest what has happened to the families of Sir Dr. Peter Odili, in particular the wife, who of course is a justice of the Supreme Court. You recall, sometimes, more than a year now, she was in a panel that gave judgment in Bayelsa State. After that judgment, that throughout the APC candidate, Lion, members or those who were not happy went and barricaded her residence. The federal government never issued any statement against that. That, of course, shows the intimidation of the federal government against the judiciary. So it is good to let you know how consistent or the pattern the federal government has taken. 4 months ago, you recall that her husband, Dr. Peter, traveled out of the country. And when he came back, the federal government seized his passport. And of course, after a series of letters were written, they denied that they didn't know about the seizure of his passport until when he went to court for the enforcement of fundamental human rights. That was when the immigration came out to say, yes, we took his passport because his name was placed on the watch list. But that tells you a man left the country and he passed through the immigration and the rest of it and traveled and came back. It was when he came back at the airport, he took his passport. And no reason was given. And the nurse who had been until the court recently gave judgment that you can't do this, it is not proper. Now, we have just 2 days ago, precisely on Friday the 29th, the residence of Justice Merodley was invaded by federal government security agencies. Yes, we have read comments, we have read reactions from various security agencies denying that they don't know anything about it. It's curious. If you look at the application made by this police to obtain a search warrant from a magistrate court to search the residence of number 9, Imo Street. There's nothing like Imo Street. What we have is Imo River. But to search number 9, and the magistrate granted. And then, Justice Smith's residence is not number 9. The smaller residence is number 7. Now, it tells you, can security operatives apply to a magistrate court, as they said, illegal activities taking place in number 9, to them, in most it. Now, that means that you know where the illegal activity is taking place, because you couldn't have applied for a search warrant where you don't know where that illegal activity or activities taking place. So you know that it is in Hilton. You know that it is in Sheraton. And so you made the application to say it is in Sheraton that the so-called illegal activities taking place. Or it is in Hilton that you said the illegal activities taking place. So it is not a question of we are not sure. We are not sure. It's not a question of we are not sure. You know. And so you applied. Now, why not go in the evening to invade Justice Menedley's residence? The husband was not in town. The husband was in Port Harcourt. So if the federal government is saying now that they are not involved, then the onus is on the federal government to come out, not just merely denying that we are not involved. We must see the steps you have taken to prove that you are not involved. And having known that a magistrate was the one who gave that order, and having known it was the police that applied for such order, or such order. So you cannot now say there are people you don't know. The names of the policemen are there. The so-called whistleblower, one Aliyu Umar, is there. So mere denial is not going to satisfy rivers state people. Mere denial will not, because look at the pattern. She was in the panel that gave judgment against the APC. They came and invaded the house. Federal government never reacted to it. How can you invade a Supreme Court justice because a judgment was given against you? They seized the husband's passport for no reason, for no explanation. Then the next year, seeing that their house has been invaded. So this is what we have come to tell the world, that if anything happens to them, federal government should be held responsible, because there are no two ways. And we are giving them 48 hours ultimatum to come up and tell Nigerians this is what they have done. So we are telling the world to know, if anything happens to the family of Dr. Peter Odili, the federal government should be held accountable, because they have shown that there's something they are about carrying out. If anything happens to my Lord Justice Many Odili, the husband and his children, the federal government should be held responsible. And that is the position of the Rivers State government and the Rivers people. We are tired of newspaper, we are tired of electronic media telling them that we have set up a proper, that is not, we are not going to, because you have set up proper several times. You have told people to go and investigate several times, and nothing has come out of the investigation. We thank God Almighty that Justice Many Odili was not killed. We thank God that the family members were not killed, but for the intervention of Rivers people who were in Abuja and who moved in before the criminals ran away. So I thank all Rivers people who were in Abuja to make sure that this whoever must have masterminded this plot did not